Hello friends. In this video, I will teach you how to make rain, snow, smoke, and fire in animation. Click the subscribe button below the video to see the next tutorials. First, I click on the script section and then I select the particle effects option. I click on the energy cloud option. In this setting, I can choose the color of the cloud or smoke that is created. I choose the color blue. You can see that the smoke is created like this. I can reposition it or make it smaller or bigger with the transform tool. We can make changes in the settings of this effect. For example, I increase its width. I change the lifetime. We can change the movement angle and height. You can see that the changes are applied well. I will delete this layer. I go back to the script section and select the explosion option. Now I determine the amount of direction and expansion. In order for you to better see how to use this effect, I put the slider in frame 109. Delete this effect and select it again so that it starts from frame 109 of the explosion. I change the location of the explosion layer with the transform tool. Now you can see that when the character lands, an explosion occurs. You can use this effect in similar situations. Now I select the rain layer. You can see that an ellipse is created at the top that I can change its location. If I move the slider forward, it will rain. We can also make changes in the settings of this effect. For example, I reduce the rainfall. I reduce the lifetime of the rain and you see the changes. We can change the width, height, and depth of rain. By reducing the width, I can create a shower mode. I can also change the speed and direction of the rain. You can see the result by changing the rate. Sometimes we need it to rain only in certain frames. For example, we don't want it to rain at the beginning of the animation, and we want to create rain in the continuation of the animation. To do this, I double-click on the rain layer. I activate this option. I set the opacity to 0 and press the apply button. I put the slider in frame 1. Now I put the slider at frame 30 and set the option to 100. It's still raining. I set the opacity to 0 in frame 24 and press the OK button. Now you can see that a part of the timeline is colored red, which shows that it does not rain from frame 0 to 24 and it rains in the rest of the animation. I remove the rain layer. I choose the smoke effect. I can change the smoke color and other settings like style and amount of smoke here. You see, smoke and fire are created for us. I also remove this effect. Now I choose the snow effect. I create a dark background so that we can see the snow. And you can see that snow is created. Exactly the same settings that we checked for the rain effect are also available for the snow. This time I will select sparkles and set its color. Spark mode is created for us. And I can change its location. Each of these effects have similar settings that we have checked all of them and we can change them. Thank you for being with me until the end of this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Bye until the next video.